Well, I believe that the members of the National Assembly should lead this particular national conversation. And the political parties should get together under their national platform and also lead this particular conversation. The first issue is, do we need the number of political parties we have as of today? Over almost 100 political parties.
What's your answer to that?
Honestly, we don't need over 100 political parties in our electoral framework. So if we do not need 100 political parties in our electoral framework, can we put in safeguards that allows the parties to exist, but put conditions under which they can go get into the ballot? Because our ballot papers are becoming more cumbersome and very complicated for the ordinary voters. So we need a ballot paper that is user-friendly and that the Nigerian people can understand properly. So I think we need that particular national national conversation. Secondly, we need a national conversation on how to protect the ad hoc staff of the Independent National Electoral Commission. It is becoming very, very difficult in some areas. The leadership of the National Youth Service Corps refused to release corpus to go and perform ad hoc duties in some of those areas. So we had to fall back on students of federal tertiary institution in some of those areas, and even at that, some of them are also declining because of the violence that has attended our election in some of these areas. And we can't go on like this. We have been harvesting the collation officers from federal tertiary institutions, university lecturers, professors, and so on. The politicians are also going to these federal tertiary institutions to go and poach some of these lecturers, and thereby compromising the electoral process. So I think we need a national conversation where some of these things will be addressed. And we need to be very, very clear that we need to improve on the regime of the electoral process. The ordinary people of this country are completely engaged with the electoral process. They believe in the electoral process, and that is why you see people who are over 80 years going to the polling unit as early as 5 a.m. in the morning to go and wait and get a vantage position at the polling unit. So if this is what we have, if the ordinary people are engaged with the electoral process and believe in it, why is it that a section of the political elite is still holding the electoral process hostage through acts of violence and through other electoral malfeasance? I think we have need a national conversation around some of these issues. The commission, we have our own challenges. We need to improve on our logistics. But I think we have our processes under control. But the more we plan, so a section of the political elite try to plan ahead of us. And planning ahead is not on how to improve the electoral process, but on how to undermine it. Mm. And I think that we cannot go on like this.